next step? I would imagine that you go non-surgical first.
That's correct. And the idea is that we're going to go from least invasive to most invasive. And I'll do like my consultations in the office with you. So you come in, you have fibroids, and we already diagnose you're a little bit troubled. We talk about the things that we mentioned before in terms that this is not a life-changing event, except we're going to manage your symptoms, all the symptoms that we mentioned before. So we start with the simple things. Simple things are hormonal treatments. Hormonal treatments would include birth control pills, progesterone, which is a hormone. Mm-hmm. And then we go to a little bit more invasive office procedure-based interventions such as intrauterine devices. Those are usually used for contraception, but there's one that has some medication in it and can be placed inside the uterus, and that would be to control the bleeding. These are not addressing the fibroids themselves. They're just addressing the symptoms of bleeding and probably pain. Then we get into a little bit more involved. And as we saw in a little segment before, there's something called fibroid embolization. And here at our fibroid center, whenever we see patients, we basically use two professionals. We use somebody like me, a gynecologic surgeon, and then we use an interventional radiologist. Interventional radiologist is the doctor who performs those uterine fibroid embolizations. And as we saw in that little segment, is we use these small pellets that go and block the blood flow to the fibroids, a non-invasive procedure. And then these fibroids basically die, and then they shrink. And the symptoms, the heavy bleeding, all go away. So then we start going into the more surgical procedures, things that I do. And nowadays, even if your fibroids are large, we are doing a lot of in a minimally invasive approach. And what that means is that before we used to basically open the abdomen in order to be able to take these fibroids out. But now we are able, through a platform of robot that we can use very small incisions in the belly and a camera, and then operate inside the abdomen. And the benefit to the patient is that they can get back to work usually in 2 weeks versus 6 weeks for an incision, a big incision. And the patient's symptoms are also taken care of.